Harris has just declared that tackling inflation will be a day one priority for her. It's going to be day one. But day one, really, for Kamala was 3.5 years ago. Where has she been? And why hasn't she done it? Why hasn't she done it? I think I'm entitled to personal attacks. I don't have a lot of respect for her. I don't have a lot of respect for her intelligence. And I think she'll be a terrible president. She certainly attacks me personally. She actually called me weird. He's weird. It was just a soundbite. And she called JD and I weird. He's not weird. He was a great student at Yale. You know, they tell me I should be nice. They want to put me in prison. It's never happened before in the history of our country. I did nothing wrong. The tags very much. Look at that. Up 46% eggs. Wow. Up 65%. Wow. School lunch is up 65%.
Trump fielded questions this morning from reporters as Kamala Harris continues to shy away from any interactions with the press. Let's go to Annalise Nielsen, our Washington correspondent. She joins us live. Annalise, Donald Trump responded to some criticism from the Harris campaign.
Look, he did, and this is starting to be the real story. 25 days since Kamala Harris became the Democrat nominee, the presumptive one taking over after Joe Biden stepped down, and she hasn't done a press conference, she hasn't done any interviews, she's taken a few questions on the tarmac going onto the plane, and that is extraordinary in this context. So Donald Trump, by doing this, was obviously trying to draw that juxtaposition, and really, when you watch this, he gave that very lengthy 45-minute intro. It droned on, it was not that exciting. When he started taking questions, the back and forth with the reporters, it was a real hint of the old Donald Trump coming back. And I think this will actually be quite a turning point in this campaign, because whether you think Kamala Harris isn't doing press because she can't, what you do know is she's not doing it. She won't do it. And that's going to be a focal point in this election if Donald Trump keeps doing events like this and generating news lines.
I don't have a lot of respect for her. I don't have a lot of respect for her intelligence. And I think she'll be a terrible president. And I think it's very important that we win. And whether the personal attacks are good, bad, I mean, she certainly attacks me personally. She actually called me weird. He's weird. It was just a soundbite. And she called JD and I weird. He's not weird. He was a great student at Yale.
Pete, the other thing that Kamala Harris hasn't been doing through her campaign is saying what her policies are. There's nothing listed on the website. What her campaign says is would be inappropriate to put those policies up because she's not yet been formally confirmed as the candidate until she is confirmed at the Democratic National Convention, which will happen next week. But the major caveat to that is she's the vice president. She's been in this administration, so those policies are well and truly out there. And don't forget, she's also the casting vote in the Senate. So she's approved every bit of legislation that's gone through the Senate. If there's been a tie, she's the tiebreaker. So she's supporting all that legislation with that incredible power that's put to her. Donald Trump also spoke about this when he was asked by reporters.
So she is saying when she gets in, she's in now. And especially with Biden, because, I mean, he's not in the best of shape. But you know what? She's in there now. She can do anything she wants. And she's still saying, if you elect me, I'll do this, I'll do... Why didn't she do it? Here's my one question, or it's the easiest question. Because she complains about everything. Why didn't she do it? That's all I ask.
Pete, we did see Kamala Harris and Joe Biden today. They hosted their own event. This is the first time we've seen both of them together since Joe Biden stepped down as the presidential nominee for the Democrats. He was very supportive of Kamala Harris in this event. He seemed very happy. They were talking about how they think that they've lowered costs for prescription medication for people across America through their administration's work. And Joe Biden also took aim at Donald Trump.
The guy we're running against, what's his name? Donald Dump or Donald whatever.
Pete, and these are the pictures that have been coming through from Afghanistan that we haven't heard a response from Joe Biden and we haven't heard a response from Kamala Harris, but they are extraordinary and are worth mentioning for our viewers. This is released from the Taliban, video footage showing the $7 billion in US military equipment that was left in that chaotic withdrawal from Afghanistan that happened 3 years ago this week. This is going to be remembered in this campaign. And remember, Kamala Harris, in an interview when asked about that policy and what happened when Joe Biden made that call, she said, "I was the last one in the room with him and I supported everything we did."